فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The mustatir, on the other hand, is categorized into two. A mustatir which is wujuban and a mustatir which is jawazan. Wujuban means a place. So wujub means al ism which is mustatir, a pronoun which is mustatir wujuban, it has to be hidden, is huwa alladhi la yahillu mahalluhu al-ismu al-zahir. A apparent noun can never stand in its place. Like for example, idhab. You can't bring a apparent noun. And the likes of that. Then the jawazan is huwa alladhi yahillu mahallahu al-ism al-zahir. A ism zahir can come into its place. Such as, for example, the word yaqumu. Yaqumu. Are you with me? What about aqumu then, brothers? What is it? Aqumu, can you bring a ism zahir? Yeah? Yeah? No, you can't, because the word aqumu in it is, it's that I'm standing. Okay? What about tajtahidu? Yeah? Can I say tajtahidu Muhammadun? And I mean that person I'm talking to. No, I can't. Ism zahir, if it comes here, it's going to look like it will go off this person and go towards another person. It's another Muhammad. No one will. Are you with me, brothers? Nusafiru, we're traveling. Hey? Yeah? Can you say Nusafiru? Muhammad Ali. Can you say that? Yeah, brothers? No. All of that, it has to be ism zahir, cannot take its place. And that's wujuban. Okay? Pay attention. So the dhamair are three types, as we said. First one is dhamir, which is al-mutakallim, which is ana wa nahnu. And then the second type is dhamir al-mukhatab, which is anta, anti, antuma, antum, antunna. Okay? And then the third one, which is dhamir al-ghaib, which is huwa, wa hiya, wa huma, wa hum, wa hunna. Okay, brothers? That's the first type of what? That's the first type of, that the author mentions from the five types of ma'rifah, right? Are you with me, brothers? The second type was what? Ismul alam, right? The second one is al-alam. Al-alam means a name. And a name is well known, right? It's ma'rifah, it's definite. That's your name. It specifically speaks about you, okay? And scholars, they categorize the alam, the names, into two. Alam al-shakhsi, personal name, and a alam jinsi, a name for a essence, or a gen, or more like essence. And alam al-shakhs means your name. Mahmoud, Muhammad, Ahmed, Khalid, that's it. Okay, and the second one is alam, which is al-jins. Are you with me, brothers? Like any name that was placed for, like for example, the name Osama. Osama was originally placed for what? A lion. It's a jins, but the humans share it. So the essence is shared by everybody, okay? But you'll never see a lion called Mahmoud. Mahmoud is a human's name. This is alam of a shakhs, a human. Are you with me? Whereas Osama is more of the jins. Animals and humans, they share it because they're all creations of Allah. They share this now. The third one is ismul mubham. Sorry, the third now, we finish alam now. We spoke about what alam means. The author mentions an ismul mubham. And this is, when we say ismul mubham, what does it fall back to? We already spoke about this. Al-ishara ana al-ism mawsool. So this is where ism mubham, which is either ismu ishara, da and thee and thih and ti and tih, da and thayni, okay, tani, tayni, awla'i, all of those. Mawsool is what? Mawsool is what? Connective. It's alladhi, allati, alladani, alladayni, allatani, allatayni, alladina, ula, واللاتي واللائي. That's that one. The fourth one that the author mentions is the ism which enters in it, alif al-lam, like rajul, and it becomes al-rajul, ghulam, al-ghulam. Okay? The fifth one is anyone ما أضيف لواحد من هذه الأربعة. Any of these four, whoever it's attributed to. So جاء خدمك خادمك وخادم محمود وخادم هذا وخادم الذي قدم وخادم الشيخ. That's all of the four that we previously mentioned. That is, so the ضمير, the اسم العلم, اسم المبهم, اسم اسم مبهم, and الاسم الذي فيه ألف واللام. All four of them, if they إضافة is done, those four that were previously mentioned, then that is معرف as well. So for example, you say جاء خادمك, جاء خادمك, صح؟ وخادم محمود وخادم هذا وخادم الذي قدم وخادم الشيخ. What's the strongest معرفة? The strongest معرفة is لفظ الجلالة, Allah. So scholars who say that the ضمير is stronger than even the علم, they're right, but they have to bring Allah's name out of it. Okay? So Allah's name is what? أعرف المعارف. Is the Allah. And it doesn't go to anyone except Allah. ولذلك, some of the scholars, they mention that all the tyrant leaders that came, all the جبابرة that came, none of them ever called themselves Allah. It's just Allah turned them away from that. They claimed to be ilah, they came, but never did they ever adopt the name what? They never adopted the word Allah. No, not in any way, form, or shape. Okay. Then the author, rahimahullah, speaks about al-nakira. Okay, he speaks about what? النكرة والنكرة كل اسم شائع في جنسه لا يختص به واحد دون آخر وتقريبه كل ما صلح دخول الألف واللام عليه نحو الرجل والفرس. نكرة is indefinite. It doesn't fall to a particular individual. رجل, man, if here it can be anyone. Okay. It's a noun that doesn't restrict itself to a particular individual. It does not restrict itself to a particular individual. An example for that is الرجل and الفرس. And the author said وتقريبه, to get the matter close to you, is whatever will allow for ألف اللام to enter it. So رجل, الرجل, فرس, الفرسي. نعم.
باب العطف. وحروف العطف عشرة, وهي الواو والفاء وثم وأو وأن وإما وبل ولا ولكن وحتى في بعض المواضع. فإن عطفت بها على مرفوع رفعت أو على منصوب نصبت أو على مخفوف خفضت أو على مجرور أو على منزوم جزمت. تقول قام زيد وعمر ورأيت زيد وعمر ومررت بزيد وعمر وزيد لم يقم ولم يقل.
The author رحمه الله goes into عطف. The word عطف in the language, it means الميل, to lean towards something. الميل عطف. That's what the Arabs, they say, عطف فلان على فلان أي مال إليه بالرفق والرحمة. That's what عطف, it means to be, have mercy towards somebody. And it's to be tenderness towards a person. It's when your heart leans towards a person, you've got a soft spot for them. According to the grammarians, they categorize it into two, عطف بيان and عطف نسق. Okay, they categorize the عطف into two, عطف بيان and عطف نسق. عطف بيان is, as we said before, it means عطف البيان, it is التابع الجامد الموضح لمتبوعه في المعارف والمخصص له في النكرات. It follows the name, okay, and it clarifies it, it makes it clear. And it also even والمخصص له في النكرات. And then that's something else we spoke about when we were talking in الورقات. For example, now جاء محمد أخوك. أخوك is actually, you're restricting which Muhammad it right now is. It could have been any Muhammad, but you've restricted it.
Isn't that better?
Yeah?
Isn't that better?
We're going to talk about how close this is. and the difference between the two. We're going to talk the difference between about بدل and عطف. We'll speak about it. جاء محمد أخوك. Because عطف بيان and بدل are always. Some scholars, they say it's the same. Because you know in the Arabic language, when you read ما بعد أي, you know the use of the word أي, ألف يا. And then scholars are trying to clarify something. This is, scholars call it, some call it ما بعد أي عطف بيان أو بدل. It can be عطف بيان or it can be بدل, whichever of them. So we'll talk about it, if there is a difference, what's the difference between those who say it's a difference. And maybe not today, maybe not in this book. We'll leave it for تميمة الأجرمية. جاء محمد أخوك. Your brother came, Muhammad, your brother came, Muhammad. So now we know that Muhammad is his brother. We clarified that for him. Okay? It became clear now. Also Allah says in the Quran, مِن مَاءٍ صَدِيدٍ. مِن مَاءٍ صَدِيدٍ. The word صَدِيد is عَطْفُ بَيَانٍ عَلَى مَاءٍ. Water. It clarifies it, explains it to you. It even restricts what type of water it is. Okay? It's not now unrestricted. It's called, that's what usuliyin, they call it mukhassis. It's that which does takhsis. And also, atfu nasq. Atfu nasq is basically the tabi'u al-mutawassit baynahu wa bayna matbu'i ahad al-huruf al-ashara. There are 10, these 10 that the author mentioned are between it. Whenever you see these 10 between it, you always need to know it's what? It's an atf. For example, the waw would be qadima aliyun, ali came, wa abuhu, and his father. The fa would be, the fa, by the way, it shows at-tartibu ma'a at-ta'qib. It shows sequence and order. For example, dakhala 'inda ash-shaykh al-ulama'u fal-muraqibuna. Okay? It shows that the order of something happening and how it took place. Thumma comes. Thumma again shows tartib. تولى الخلافة أبو بكر ثم عمر ثم عمر سوري. أو is again تنويع أو لأحد الشيئين. It's basically تخيير الإباحة, choosing between two things. جاء محمد أو خالد أم is basically used تستعمل لطلب التعيين, when you're actually looking to specify after the Hamza to, after the Hamza to الاستفهام. أم, for example, أجاء, there always has to be the beginning after the, it has to be a question form. So you will say أجاء محمود, did محمود come, أم صالح or صالح. In other words, what you're trying to say is أيهما جاء, which of those two came, right? That's what you're trying to say. The word إما is like أو. As Allah said in the Quran, سبحانه وتعالى, فإما من نم بعد وإما فداء. Okay? It's also from the حروف, the حروف العطفي. The seventh one is بل. Okay? بل. And it means, of course, definite. Okay? بل is actually more stronger than the word نعم. It's actually more stronger. It's 100%. So ما جاء يوسف بل إبراهيم. Yusuf did not come. Rather Ibrahim came. Rather Ibrahim came. لا هي is, for example, قديم صالح لا محمود. صالح came, not محمود. And the word لكن is ما رأيت بليدا لكن مجتهدا. And the لكن here, which you're trying to do, is, and the word لا, both of them have one thing in common. The لا that I mentioned before and the لكن, both of them are actually, they're going to affirm the direct opposite of what was said. For example, when you say قديم صالح صالح came, لا محمود محمود did not come, you're fully negating it from محمود and you're giving the opposite to صالح. لكن is also the same in العطف. You're saying ما رأيت بليدا, I didn't see a person who's not smart. لكن مجتهدا, rather what I saw was a مجتهد, a person of اجتهاد. حتى is what the author uses to استعمل للغاية. حتى is used for what? غاية. What's حتى used for? It's used for what? غاية. The ultimate goal. يموت الناس, the people will die. حتى الأنبياء, even the prophets are going to die. قديم الحجاج, the people of Hajj have come. حتى المشاة, نعم, even the مشاة, the walkers have also come. So حتى is حرف من حروف العطف. Then the author رحمه الله, he mentions the ruling for these 10. فإذا عطفت بهم بها على مرفوع رفعت أو على منصوب نصبت أو على مخفوض خفضت أو على مجزوم جزمت. And he tells you the ruling that if what's before it is مرفوع, رفع, you make it مرفوع. For example, قام زيد وعمر. Okay. وإن كان منصوبا نصب. If it's منصوب, you place نصب on it, right? رأيت زيدا وعمرا. Okay. وإن كان مخفوضا خفضا. It becomes مررت بزيد وعمر. وإن كان مجزوما جزما. And it becomes زيد لم يقم ولم يقعد. Okay. نعم.
باب التوكيد. التوكيد تابع للمؤكد برفعه ونصبه وقبضه وتعريفه, ويكون بألفاظ معلومة وهي النفس والعين وكل أجمع, والتوابع أجمع وهي أتع وأبتع وأبصع. تقول قام زيد نفسه ورأيت القوم كلهم
The author, rahimahullah, now goes into a tawkid. Tawkid in the Arabic language, it means a taqwiyah, is when you're basically strengthening and emphasizing on something. And according to the grammarians, it's categorized into two. The first one is tawkidul lafzi, a word-based tawkid. Okay, and the way it is that the same word is repeated twice. Ja'a Muhammadun, Muhammadun. Muhammad came, Muhammad. So, طلعت الشمس لا لا أقوم. Those are called توكيد لفظي. The same word is repeated twice. Then the second is توكيد معنوي. And توكيد معنوي, which is what? وهو الذي يرفع احتمال إضافة إلى المتبوع أو الخصوص بما ظاهره العموم. For example, جاء بكر نفسه, which is the ones that the author is bringing. The wording is not going to come again, but now what's going to come is what's going to come is something that has the possibility of attributing it إلى المتبوعي. Okay? For example, جاء بكر, بكر came. نفسه, himself. That's توكيد معنوي for بكر. Okay? And all of these are the examples that here the author brought, رحمه الله تعالى, which fall under توكيد المعنوي. Which is النفس والعين وكل وأجمع. Okay, all of those are words that are used for توكيد. Which توكيد are we talking about here? Yeah, we're talking about the second, which is the معنوي. As for if it's لفظي, then the word itself will repeat itself twice. توكيد معنوي, according to the grammarians, it fulfills a job known as مخصوصة. It makes it specific. So we have nafsu, which is you. Aynu is because this ayn means this essence, this thing itself. Kullu, you know what it means. Ajma', you know what it means. And the word ajma' has things that come under it, that stem under it. It's ajma's kol. It is group. It's like akta'u, wa abta'u, wa absa'u. All of those are the same meaning as ajma'. They all mean the same. Okay? They're basically three letters that are used by the Arabs, which all mean the same. They mean ajma, all of. They all show, and they have one thing in common, which is ihata wa shumul. And ihata, they encompass everything, and they're very generic. That's the second type. So what did I say the tawkid is? The tawkid is two types, lafzi and ma'anawi. Lafzi means that the same word repeats itself twice. Ma'anawi means what, brothers? Ma'anawi means that any of these wordings, if they are used, then that means it is meaning-based, okay? It's meaning-based. So if it happens that when we hear the word, for example, فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ, according to the grammarians, which is, I said, Su'ul Adab to say that in the, regarding the Quran, but for them, it would be Tawqeed Ma'nawi. Okay? Are you with me, brothers? Because كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ, they believe it is, it's كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ has entered here is Ma'nawi. The angels, it didn't say فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, صح? If it would, then it would be lofty, right? But what happened here is the word kul is brought back, which really encompasses all of the angels. Okay? Yeah, Tawqeed lofty, yeah, it'll be for them. Naam. Because the same word has been repeated twice. Even now that we believe, as Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentions, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, aminu. Those of you who believe again, it means that your iman is naqis and deficient, completed. What's left, completed. And this is one of the ayat Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen said that. It's rare that the ulama of Salaf actually use this to prove that the iman increases and decreases. Are you with me? In little, you find anyone use that as evidence. Yeah? Yeah? Yeah, it's one of the ayats that scholars use. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, those of you who believe. Aminu, believe. So if the iman was complete, why would Allah say believe? Huh? So this is a refutation on that? Murji'a, who believe that the iman doesn't increase. Or does it decrease? Naam.
باب التوكيد. التوكيد تابع للمؤكد.
You got توكيد, right?
Yeah. باب البدل. إذا أطل اسم من اسم أو فعل من فعل تبعه في جميع أعوابه وهو أربعة أقسام. بدل شيء من شيء وبدل بعض من كل وبدل الاشتمال وبدل الغلط نحن قولك قام زيد أخوك وأكلت الرغيف ثلثه ونفعني زيد عمله ورأيت زيدا الفارس أردت أن تقول الفارس فغلطت فأبدلت زيدا منه.
The author رحمه الله, he mentions that the badal is four types. Badal al-shay'i min al-shay'i, which is also called badal al-mutabaq. If the grammarians ever say badal al-shay'i min al-shay'i, it's also known as badal al-mutabaq. Badal al-mutabaq, you always just need to remember the dhabit for it. The dhabit for the badal, you will be brothers. Sorry, I just need to explain what badal means first of all. Badal is al-iwad. What does badal mean? Iwad, you guys know, swap. Okay, you're swapping two things. So what happens is that sometimes people swap things, right, in grammar. So these are from the tawabi'. If it's marfu', it becomes, if it's raf' happens to what it's following, it becomes marfu'. Ja'a Muhammadun akhuka. Okay, nasabahu, it becomes mansub. Ra'aytu Muhammadan akhaka. Farihtu bi Muhammadin akhika. In tasjud lillahi tashkuruhu yarhamka. All of that is what that the badal does. The badal is four types, as the author mentioned. The first type is called badal al-shay'i min al-shay'i, and it's also called badal al-mutabaq. The dhabit for it is what, brothers? Dhabit here means, what is it that you as an individual need to know and understand regarding badal? It's important. How can I really tell the difference between each one? The way you can tell the difference between each one is al-badal al-mutabaq is ما يكون أن يكون ما أريد بالثاني عين ما أريد بالأول. So basically, the thing that you're going to swap the other thing for is actually exactly the same. For example, قام زيد أخوك. زيد, your brother stood. So زيد and brother is the same, exactly the same. They're the exactly same thing. Okay, that's why I said the عطف بيان and the بدل here kind of mix up. So there's something that some of the grammarians mention, but going into that tafasil and that details right now, it's unnecessary. Okay? But for now, what you can do is you can say the atful bayan, whatever is also badal. But what badal? Badalu shay'i min al-shay'i. Okay? The second one is badalu ba'di min al-kulli. Okay? Badalu ba'di min al-kulli means that basically they're not exactly the same, but it's a part of it. It's a part of it, portion of it. For example, akaltu al-ragifa thuluthahu. I ate the bread, one third of it. That's not, what you ate is not the whole bread, it's part of the bread. So there's the other parts of the bread that's still not eaten by you. The third one is badalul ishtimali. Okay, badalul ishtimali basically means that an yakuna bayna al-awwali, the first thing and the second, there's a relationship, but that relationship has nothing to do with generic relationship or specific relationship that you saw in the second one. None of that. For example, you would say, نَفَعَنِي زَيْدٌ عِلْمُهُ. Zayd's knowledge benefited me. Okay? Zayd's knowledge benefited me. Okay? Now, Zayd's knowledge is not all Zayd's. Okay? It's not all what Zayd is. Zayd's more than just knowledge. Okay? Other things of Zayd can benefit. So it's not كُلِّ بَعْضٍ. So you can't look at it from that angle. And knowledge is not a part of me as an individual. It's not a physical part of me. Okay? Does that make sense? So it doesn't fall under that. The fourth one is badalul ghalat. Badalul ghalat means when the first part and the second part have no relationship with each other whatsoever. You basically kind of got it wrong, to be honest. Okay? And it's what the author mentions here. We say, Ra'aytu Zaydan. I saw Zayd al-Faras. Al-Faras. And some of the scholars don't even add this to the tawabi', sorry, to the badal. They don't. Okay, here. There we finished. But I need to mention a qa'idah which you need to remember. The badalul ishtimal, always what you have to do is that, are you with me, brothers? The badalul ishtimal, there always has to be a pronoun that brings it back to you. So, example, nafa'ani zaydun ilmuhu. Who goes back to him? It always has to be a pronoun that brings you back to Zayd. Okay? There always has to be. Now the author, rahimahullah, we finished Babu Marfu'at al-Asma. We've now got Babu Mansubat al-Asma. We'll take a 10-minute break and then we'll do Mansubat and we'll definitely be finished on time. And then we've got once we finish the Marfu'at, we will go for Mansubat. When we finish it, we will go for the Makhfudat, which is the smallest chapter, to be honest. There's only three things that are Makhfud in the Asma. Is Jar and Idafa and Tawabi'. And Tawabi' we already spoke about, so we're not going to speak about it again. So we're really going to be speaking about Jar and Idafa. But the Mansubat is a bit much, but it's not as much as the Marfu'at. We'll take a little break, inshallah, for 10 minutes.